My favorite part about business trips? Coming back. Hi friends, welcome back to the vlog where your favorite product marketing manager travels to Beijing for the first ever business trip of 2021. And because this product marketing manager has such an easygoing personality and is not at all high maintenance, he throws his clothes into the suitcase without any regard for organization or efficiency. Just kidding, that was actually physically painful to even watch, so I take a good hour or so to pack my suitcase and arrange the packing cubes by work clothes, casual wear, gym wear, underwear, and video gear. With the check-in luggage all sorted, I then turn my attention to planning what I will do each day of the week to be as productive in Beijing as possible to make my company proud. I'm primarily traveling this time for a two-day offline event, haven't had that in a while, for external clients and partners. But because I work a lot with internal cross-functional colleagues in Beijing, I'm scheduling some time to meet with them face-to-face for catch-ups. This is definitely not required as part of the job, especially when we're traveling, but I personally find it's small things like this that make marketing campaigns run that much smoother. While referencing my calendar, I input action items I need to do on my trip planner page in Notion. On the right-hand side, I have the things I need to pack, and on the left, the colleagues I need to see and any personal plans I have outside of work. It's a simple template, but I included a link down below if you want to use it. Being a well-organized and responsible traveler, I then spend 10 to 20 minutes visualizing the places I need to be for each day. It boggles my mind how some people are able to just fly to a place and then decide where to go without writing it all down beforehand. The next day, I launch myself out of bed, excited by the prospect of spending 3+ hours on a plane crammed between crying babies and their parents. I check for the millionth time that I have my travel documents with me, go out the door, then immediately check again. On the way to the airport, I continue listening to The Motivation Myth by Jeff Hayden while simultaneously taking notes on the Todoist app on my phone. While this may not be very efficient, I still find this to be the easiest way of taking notes on a car, and I always transfer my notes afterwards to my book notes page within Notion. One of my favorite quotes so far from the book is, "Talk about the routine you want to follow to hit your goal, not what you're going to end up achieving." This basically puts emphasis on the systems and processes you follow to get to your objective rather than the end goal itself, an idea I fully agree with. At the hotel, I respond to a few urgent emails and pings and realize I don't even have time to unpack before heading back out again to the office. But as hectic as the day seems to be going, I am very excited to see my Beijing colleagues and friends in person. So, it's 11:20 p.m. I have still not unpacked yet. I have 35 unread emails. This week is gonna be super, super fun. For the next few days, I focus on the final preparations for the two-day offline event. And by me, I really mean my amazing colleague May, who planned the event from scratch. The main objective is to improve our clients' creative capabilities, so we invited creative experts as well as our sales team members as guest speakers. So our target audience this time is mobile app developers. If you think back to an app that you really enjoy using, it could be a game like Hearthstone or a productivity app like Notion. In addition to how well designed the user interface is, one of the biggest reasons you probably enjoy using it is because of the creative elements. How pretty things look, how immersive the graphics are, right? So in this event, we're really trying to train these animation specialists and in-house designers of these app development companies on creative best practices so we could empower them to develop better apps. For a training event like this, the product marketing team's responsibilities can be broadly split into three distinct categories. Number one, uncover user insights to shape the event narrative, aka what value do we bring? Number two, overall event management and execution, do the attendees have a pleasant time? And number three, post-event analysis and follow-up. What can we do even better next time? A typical planning trick for events of this scale can easily take up 10 tabs or more in a Google Sheet document. To stay organized, I like to split up the sheet into four sections. First, key information tabs in red here that tells me at a glance whether the event is on track or not. For example, if my manager pinged me randomly asking how the event planning is going, I can pull up the RSVP tab and instantly let her know whether we are over or under capacity. Then the pre-event preparation work to ensure the best experience for our clients. Third section, post-event analysis from surveys and client feedback. And finally, working tabs that let us record attendance, calculate an engagement rate, and other event-specific metrics. So if you fell asleep as I went through that, you're welcome. You probably fell asleep much faster than usual. But personally for me, I love go-to-market campaigns and project management. And even though events are just a part of what we do, other types of marketing campaigns will require similar approaches and processes. Let me know down in the comments if any of you would actually be interested in a deep dive of project or event management. Thanks to the meticulous planning of the team and the amazing quality of the speakers, the event proceeded without a hitch. Following the sharing of best practices and real-life examples, our audience split up into breakout groups to work on separate creative presentations, which our guest speakers would then give their own feedback on. After a pretty long week, my colleagues and I get together on Friday night to have a drink and relax. Being responsible adults, we of course stick to the one drink plan. We don't often get to see each other in person, so we take full advantage of this opportunity to catch up, meet new friends, and trade some harmless gossip. While I had a pretty packed schedule this week, it felt good to be back in Beijing. I always learn something new about the industry or about our clients' businesses. Although, it would be nice to come for fun at some point. Oh well, maybe next time.